हम लोग ने कल जो ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री में हम रिएक्शंस कर रहे थे, वी वर डूइंग द डिहाइड्रेशन रिएक्शंस व्हिच वी हैड डन यस्टरडे, और उसका हमने मैकेनिज्म भी डिस्कस कर लिया था. दे आर मिसलेनियस रिएक्शंस अपार्ट फ्रॉम द टू टाइप्स ऑफ क्लीवेजेस व्हिच वी डिड यस्टरडे. वन वाज की द क्लीवेज ऑफ द OH बॉन्ड जिसपे वो उसकी एसिडिक कैरेक्टर को शो कर रहा है, एंड सेकेंड इज द क्लीवेज ऑफ द CO बॉन्ड इन विच न्यूक्लियोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शंस दे वर टेकिंग प्लेस, राइट. एंड उसके बाद मिसलेनियस रिएक्शंस में हम लोगों ने कल करा था डिहाइड्रेशन रिएक्शन. डिहाइड्रेशन रिएक्शन मींस रिमूवल ऑफ वाटर, एंड द मैकेनिज्म वाज प्रोटोनेशन एंड डीप्रोटोनेशन मैकेनिज्म. एंड आई टोल्ड यू दैट द मैकेनिज्म दैट इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू योर बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन. ओके, नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू द नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शंस ऑफ अल्कोहल्स. दीज आर डिहाइड्रोजिनेशन रिएक्शंस. Dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation now means removal of hydrogen. So this can also be taken as oxidation reactions because oxidation also means removal of hydrogen. But they are more specifically known as dehydrogenation reactions because of the reagent which we are using in these particular reactions, that is copper. So in this reaction, the primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohols, they are going to behave differently. So when we talking of dehydrogenation, generally this reaction that is done in presence of copper at a temperature of 573 Kelvin. Okay, so let's go on to first primary alcohols. When we have primary alcohols of the type ethyl alcohol and we are subjecting it to copper at a temperature of 573 Kelvin. This is going to give us the respective aldehyde and hydrogen that is going to be eliminated. Okay. Second, if we're taking a secondary alcohol over here, this is the secondary alcohol. Again, the reaction conditions are kept same. Copper at 573 Kelvin, this is going to give us a ketone plus H2. But when we're taking a tertiary alcohol, it prefers undergoing dehydration rather than dehydrogenation because of the bulkier CH3 groups which are going to be present over here. So this is going to, again, when we are reacting this with copper at 573 Kelvin, this is going to give us CH3 C double bond and plus water. So it preferably undergoes dehydration to give us an alkene. Now this property that is used to distinguish between primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols. Okay, so when you're doing the dehydrogenation of primary alcohol, it is going to, the product will give us the test for aldehydes. If we're doing the dehydrogenation of secondary alcohols, the product will give us the test for ketones. And when we're doing the dehydrogenation, rather than undergoing dehydrogenation, the tertiary alcohols, they undergo dehydration. And over here, this is going to give us the test for alkenes. Alkenes ka test kya hota hai? Decolorization of bromine water. Okay, jo bromine hota hai, that is, kya kehte hai, usko brown in color. So as soon as it comes in contact with alkene or alkyne, it is going to get decolorized. So that is a test for unsaturation, that is what we call it. Then the second, next reaction which we are going to discuss over here, they are the oxidation reactions. Now over here, we use various oxidizing agents. For example, we can use K2CR2O7, we can use KMnO4, right? Potassium permanganate. We can also use dilute nitric acid. Dilute HNO3. Okay. Now over here, we will see that when we are oxidizing the primary alcohol, it is going to get oxidized to aldehydes and then it will get oxidized to acids. So we're taking a primary alcohol over here, CH3, CH2, OH, and oxidation we are doing in presence of any of the oxidizing agents which we have mentioned above, this is going to give us CH3, CHO, and further oxidation that is going to give us. Okay, so when we're doing the secondary alcohols over here, secondary alcohols is CH3C, CH3, H and OH. Oxidation of secondary alcohols, okay, over here we were doing the oxidation. This is going to give us the respective acid. ठीक है? जब secondary alcohols हम लेते हैं, this is going to give us ketones. So we have over here CH3C, CH3 and double bond O, right? And if we are taking tertiary, so tertiary does not go oxidation. It prefers undergoing dehydration as we have already done. Now over here we can use many other oxidizing agents than what we have used above, that is apart from K2Cr2O7, KMnO4 and dilute HNO3, we can also use the following oxidizing agents. We can use Jones reagent. Jones reagent, that is chromium trioxide in H2SO4, in sulfuric acid. Okay? This is Jones reagent. Or we can at higher, we see that generally the Jones reagent is used if there is a multiple bonded system which is present. Then the double bond or the triple bond that does not get affected. For example, if we have a compound like this, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pent, 2 ene, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 ine, 1 ol. Okay, so if you're doing the oxidation of this in presence of Jones reagent, it will be seen that the double and the triple bond that is not going to be affected. So we have over here CH triple bond C, CH double bond CH and CHO. There is going to be no effect on the double and the triple bond. Okay? Then at higher temperature, aldehydes, they can be easily converted into their respective acids. So if you're increasing the temperature over here further, this can be the CHO group that gets oxidized to COOH using the same reagent. Okay? Other reagents which we can use over here, the other reagents which we can use over here is aluminium tertiary butoxide. Aluminium tertiary butoxide, which has the formula okay, or we can use NBS. NBS is N-bromosuccinimide. N-bromosuccinimide. Then we can use PCC. PCC is pyridinium chlorochromate. Pyridinium chlorochromate. Okay? And then we have, if we take PCC in methylene chloride, then this is given another name. This is known as Sarex reagent. Sarex reagent. Okay? फिर उसके बाद वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज मैंगनीज डाइऑक्साइड. सो दीज आर ऑल द ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स व्हिच कैन बी यूज्ड. नाउ लेट्स जस्ट टेक अ समरी ऑफ ऑल व्हाट वी हैव डन इन आवर ऑक्सीडेशन. लेट्स टेक द रिएजेंट एंड लेट्स सी फॉर व्हाट पर्पस दैट रिएजेंट इज यूज्ड. सो ऑल द रिएजेंट्स व्हिच वी हैव डन इन दिस एंटायर चैप्टर्स, that in this particular chapter there is a small summary to all of that which I want to discuss. Okay, so if you're having a
We're just going to make a table. We are taking a reagent and we are taking the reaction on which this reagent that is going to have an effect, so that if you're getting filling the blanks in your NEET or your JEE, you can easily do that by learning this particular table. So over here we have the first one, which is chromic acid. Chromic acid has the formula H2CrO4. The purpose of chromic acid is to convert 1 degree alcohol to carboxylic acid. So this is again an oxidizing agent only. It will convert 1 degree alcohol first to aldehydes and then to carboxylic acid. Okay? Second hypers are gaya PCC, pyridinium chlorochromate, pyridinium dichromate. Okay? And we have another reagent, which is, this will be written as DMSO. Okay, now this is going to convert 1 degree alcohol to 1 aldehyde, and it will convert 2 degree alcohol to ketone without affecting the double bond. So this is important, without affecting the double bond. Okay, sometimes you get a question ki which reagent will be used for the conversion of the following reaction. So over here, if there's a double bond present and you are converting 1 degree to aldehyde and 2 degree to ketone, then the reagents which we will use is going to be PCC, PDC or DMSO. Okay, fir uske baad next hamare paas aata hai Jones reagent is CrO3 in H2SO4. This is going to convert 2 degree alcohol to ketone, right? And then we have, this will also convert 1 degree alcohol to aldehyde. So it's the same, 1 degree to aldehyde. Okay? Then uske baad we come to manganese dioxide. Another oxidizing agent which is used, it is going to be used to oxidize allylic, benzylic, 1 degree, 2 degree alcohol to give aldehydes and ketones. So allylic and benzylic, 1 degree and 2 degree to aldehydes and ketones, right? And then we have silver carbonate, Ag2CO3 in benzene. This is going to be used to convert 1 degree to aldehyde, 1 degree alcohol to aldehyde and 2 degree alcohol to ketone. So mostly you can see that 1 degree is converted to aldehyde and 2 degree to ketone. If there is specifically a double bond or triple bond present, you can either use Jones reagent or you can use PCC and PTSC. So these are certain specific oxidizing agents which are used for different purposes, right? So with this we finish our alcohols. Now over here we have certain methods by which we can distinguish 1 degree, 2 degree and 3 degree alcohols. Let's see what are those tests. Alright, so let's go on to the methods of distinguish or distinction. Test for distinction. Of 1 degree, 2 degree and 3 degree alcohols. The first test is the Lucas test. This we have already discussed, in which we are using or we are reacting the alcohol with
acid, HCl in presence of ZnCl2, where turbidity that is going to appear. We've already done this test. So Lucas test where 3 degree will get turbidity as soon as the halogen acid that is going to react with the alcohol, then it is 2 degree and 1 degree only on heating. So if as soon as you are mixing the alcohol with the respective aldehyde, or you can say with the respective halogen acid, and turbidity appears immediately, it means it is a 3 degree alcohol. If it appears after a little while, it is 2 degree alcohol. And if it appears only after heating, then it is going to be 1 degree alcohol. So this is one very common test. The second test which we have, that is the dichromate test. Dichromate test, it is also known as oxidation test. Okay. Now over here what we do is we take the alcohol, the sample, and we are going to add this. To this we are going to add sodium dichromate in dilute H2SO4. In dilute H2SO4, when we get one orange solution, right? Now when this orange solution turns to green, then it is a primary alcohol. Okay, so this orange solution turns to green, then it is going to be 1 degree alcohol. If it is turned to green but with the formation of a ketone, then it is going to be 2 degree, okay? And if there is no color change, if there is no color change, then it is going to be 3 alcohol, okay? So this is one test, but one very common test which we generally do, that is the Victor-Meyer's test. So let's see what is this Victor-Meyer test. There are various steps to this step and different color changes which are going to take place. This is one of the best tests. One is the Lucas test and the other one, that is the Victor-Meyer's test. These are one of the best tests to distinguish between 1 degree, 2 degree and 3 degree alcohols. Okay, so let's go on to the Victor-Meyer's test. So just go to form a table over here. We are taking a primary alcohol, 1 degree alcohol. We are taking a secondary alcohol and we are taking a tertiary alcohol, right? So primary alcohol is going to be RCH2OH, secondary alcohol is going to be RCHOH, and tertiary alcohol is going to be RNOH. Okay? So first of all, in the first step, we are going to react all the samples with phosphorus and iodine, red phosphorus we are using over here, or HI. Right? So this is going to give us RCH2I. Okay? उसी तरह से इसके साथ जब हम करेंगे, this is going to give us R2CHI and this is going to give us R3CI. All the OH, they are going to be substituted by the iodine. Then you react this with silver nitrite, AgNO2, with the iodine that is going to be substituted again by the nitro group. Okay? Similarly over here also,
case of tertiary also. R3CNO2, right? Then finally, we are going to react this with nitrous acid, HONO. When we are going to get over here a compound of the type NOH and NO2, right? And when you are reacting the secondary alcohol compound with HNO2, this is going to give us whereas with this there is going to be no reaction. Right? Further now, if you are dissolving the final compound in NaOH for primary alcohols, we are going to get blood red color. Okay? Whereas this, when reacted with NaOH, is going to give us blue color. And over there, there is going to be no reaction, or in other words, we can say that it is going to be colorless. So, all these series of reactions, if it is giving us blood red color, it means the sample is primary alcohol. If it is giving us blue color, the sample is secondary alcohol. And if there is no color, then it is going to be tertiary alcohol. Okay, then let's do two commercially important compounds which are in your syllabus. One is methyl alcohol and the other one that is ethyl alcohol. Some commercially important alcohols. The first one that is known as methyl alcohol with the formula CH3OH, IUPAC name methanol, and this is also known as carbinol. Okay, this is also known as carbinol. Now this is going to be the simplest monohydric alcohol. This is the simplest kind of monohydric alcohol. It also has some other name depending upon the source from which it is obtained. It is known as wood alcohol. It is known as wood spirit. It is also known as wood nectar. Right? Now it occurs in combined states in various compounds. For example, it occurs in oil of wintergreen. These common names you must remember. Oil of wintergreen, that is methyl salicylate. Ethyl salicylate. Okay? Then second we have oil of cloves. Clove oil. You know what clove is? Kya bolte isko long. Okay? So jo oil of long hota hai, usme bhi ye present hota hai in the form of methyl benzoate. Okay? And then it is also present in oil of orange flowers in the form of methyl anthralylate. Okay, so these are some of the common compounds in which it is present. Now when we're looking at the uses
of methyl alcohol, you can write down number one, it is used as a solvent for oils, fats, paints, varnishes. Number two, it is used for the manufacture of formaldehyde. Number three, it is also used as a fuel. Spelling F-U-E-L. Right, it is used as a fuel. It is also used as an antifreeze for automobile radiators. Antifreeze for automobile radiators. Then it is also used in perfumery industry. And finally, it is also used for denaturing ethyl alcohol. Denaturing means making it unfit for drinking. Denaturing ethyl alcohol. Okay, so this was methyl alcohol. Next, let's go on to the second compound, which is ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol, that is also known as methyl carbinol. It is also known as methyl carbinol, and it has the formula C2H5OH. Okay? Now this is going to be one of the most important members of the homologous series of alcohols. It is also known as spirit of wine, because most of the liquors or wine, they are going to have ethyl alcohol as one of the major components, which is going to give the intoxicating effect to all the liquors. Okay? Then this is also known as grain alcohol, because generally it is formed by the fermentation of grain. Okay? So isliye isko grain alcohol bhi bulate hain. Now there are various types of alcohols which we are going to discuss over here, but you should know how much of C2H5OH is going to be present. The first one, that is known as absolute alcohol. In case of absolute alcohol, there is 100% ethanol present. Okay, there is going to be 100% ethanol present. Second is denatured alcohol. Now alcohol, ethyl alcohol, that is made unfit for drinking purposes, in which there are certain other commodities which are added. For example, we generally add methanol, we add pyridine is added to give it a foul smell, and then we also use aqueous copper sulfate, which is going to give blue color to the normal alcohol, and the person is unable to drink this alcohol. That is why it is known as denatured alcohol. Okay, so over here, this consists of basically 95% ethanol plus 5% methanol plus pyridine, little amount of pyridine to give it a foul smell, and plus aqueous copper sulfate to give it a slight blue tinge. So that is how it becomes unfit for drinking.
The third type of alcohol which we have over here, that is known as methylated spirit. That is known as methylated spirit. It is 90% ethanol. Ethanol plus 9% methanol. Plus 1% pyridine. So this is methylated spirit. Okay, this is used in spirit lamps. And then we have power alcohol. Power alcohol. Power alcohol is used for generating power. Right? It's a substitute for gasoline and it consists of 20% ethyl alcohol plus 80% gasoline. Okay? So this is power alcohol. So these are the four kinds of alcohols which we've done over here. Now when we're looking at uses of ethyl alcohol, the most important use is that it is used for the preparation of alcoholic beverages. Right? So all this beer, whiskey, wine, everything in that, this is one of the most important component. And it is also used in as a solvent in various pharmaceutical industries. Okay, so these are the two uses, the important uses of ethyl alcohol. With this we finish our alcohols, the first part of the chapter. Now we are only left with phenols and ethers, which we should finish in another two classes. Okay, so we finish this chapter and then we go on to aldehydes and ketones.